convert the following numbers into scientific notation. Now first we have to say, well, what is scientific notation? What does that mean? Scientific notation is a special way to write numbers, say, usually used for very large or very small numbers. And scientific notation basically says we must have a number. We generally call it this form. The form is called A times 10 to the nth power. That's what we generally think of as a scientific notation, where A must fall between 1 inclusive and 10 exclusive. And N is an integer. So, here we have, we're asked to talk about the Microsoft Corporation market capitalization on April 1st, 2010, which was $256 billion. So, to get this into scientific notation, basically the way I like to think of it is, first locate the decimal. So, the decimal here is right there. It's right at the end of the number. Move the decimal so that we have a number between 1 and 10. So if I move this decimal to right there, between the 2 and the 5, I have a number between 1 and 10. So I would have then 2.56 times 10 to a power. Now, what is the power? Well, the power is basically the number of places I moved the decimal point. So let's see, 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. I moved it 11 places. Now, is it a positive 11 or a negative 11? That's the question. Is it a positive or a negative? Okay, so here's the way I like to think of it. Large numbers . Now, what do I mean by large? Large numbers are far away from zero. Large numbers that are away from zero get positive exponents. Whereas small numbers, what are small numbers? Small numbers are close to zero. Small numbers get negative exponents. I should have prefaced that by saying, at least when we're talking about scientific notation. So then we'd have 2.56 times 10 to the positive 11th, because 256 billion is a large number. It's far away from zero. All right, let's look at exercise B, where we're talking about the wavelength of a certain light, and we have 0.000004 meter. We want to get this to scientific notation. All right, well, we see the decimal point, but we need to get a number between 1 and 10. Well, I would have to move the decimal to the right of that 4 to get a number in scientific notation. So then I would have 4 times 10. How many places did I move it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 places. So 7, but wait a second, is this a large number or a small number? Well, 0.000004 is pretty close to zero, negative exponent. All right, so we'd have 4 times 10 to the negative 7 meter. I should really put units on this. And 2.56 times 10 to the 11th, and the units on that would be dollars.